Today I have the pleasure of presenting this work that was led by Josefine Munk Sørensen, who's now on maternity leave, myself, and Alexander Koporska, Zoe Skovlund, and Lina Hautshorn. The starting point for the two studies that I'm presenting today is that we have had the feeling that email ratings were a bit too positive, generally in too simple context, and there was a slight disagreement, a dissonance, when you compared it to the fact that SpeechNOS still tops the list in MarketTrack. So we have carried out two studies, one called the PPLA, where we were testing for preference for brightness and noise reduction in diverse situations using EMA. And in that study, we used prompts every 2 hours asking the participants to perform EMAs. When we looked at that data, we were actually not really satisfied with it. So for the subsequent study, the output project, we decided to go in a different direction. We really wanted to sample more difficult situations, and we thought that the best way of doing that would be to simply give the test participants the full responsibility for putting in the EMAs in the challenging situations, the situations that they find challenging. And then we did that by just giving them one notification every morning saying that remember to rate your difficult situations. We're using the sound pressure level as a proxy to assess how complex the listening situations where people have been with the hearing aids and when they complete their EMAs. So we have two probability density functions of SPL. They are the blue ones, they are just from all the data that we have collected from the participants while they were in the study. And then the beige ones are the sound pressure levels during the time where they completed EMAs. If we start with the data on the during the normal logging time, we see that there are slight differences between the two studies, the PPLA and the ALBA, but in general, the most of the SPLs are above 50 and then going a little bit up. We see a much larger difference in the sound pressure level during EMA completions, where a lot of them were down at around 45 dB in the PPLA study, and we still have some at that SPL, but we also have some up at 70 dB SPL in the ALBA study. And actually, this was really what we wanted. We wanted to see if this self-initiated EMAs would cause our participants to rate the situations in more difficult situations. We were actually quite happy with the results on this previous slide, but when Josefine looked at the time series of the SPL data around the EMA completions, you could actually see additional this pattern. So at zero, this is when the participant starts filling out the EMA. And what we actually see is, and we see that in a number of the ratings, that there is a jump more or less right before people perform the EMA, and then it's just at the low levels around just also prior to the EMA, and we can also put in the SNR to see that, okay, what is the speech levels estimated by the hearing aid, and we can then say that like 45 dB is a color for realistic sound environments. So what we're seeing here, and we see that, is that this person is rating an EMA and is telling us that this is a conversation with one person inquired at home. However, the level we see here is actually so low, so it's almost impossible to speak so low. So there's something going on here. What we simply took this as an element of was that people simply go out of the situation that they were in to fill in the EMA. And this was also completely in line with what others have found, that it is socially unacceptable to bring out your phone and start rating your hearing aids when you are in a conversations with other people. You can also say there's the social part of it. There's also the fact that you're actually engaging in a conversation with another person. You don't want to take out your phone there, even despite it being socially acceptable or not. You want to engage in the in the conversation. So we see this as perhaps actually people, even though that we say that you do it in the situation, they do it afterwards. If we look at all the EMAs that were done in this ARPA study, we see that 31% of them has this drop that I just showed you before. There's also 50% that is where it's stable around the EMA time. There's some where we had some data glitches, so that's the 10%. And there's also some where the situation gets more loud afterwards. But we are focusing here mainly on the situations where the SPL drops right before the EMA. To the two categories where the intent is not conversation, then we see that we don't really have this drop. However, when the hearing aid user says that this is a conversation, then we have almost 35% of them, and then also only 40% of them are stable. So we see that when we look at this, these differences in SPL around the EMA time, they happen most early when we are in a conversation. Okay, sorry for the busy slide, but we're back to what we saw before, that there are the two probability densities with the SPL during EMA, that's the base, and during a normal logging time. As we saw before, when we just look at the raw data, we see that we get more situations with louder SPL in the ARPA over the PPLA. So the self-initiated drives the people to rate more difficult situations. But then when we apply the correction that I just showed before, then we can of course also apply that to the PPLA, and we see that also there were some of the EMAs that were done in conversation. And thus this algorithm also then shifts this a little bit to the higher level. So there were some where they were actually in louder environments right before they did the EMA. And then when we apply the same for the ARPA data, we actually see this combined effect of both the instruction where we ask people to do it self-initiated, and then also the correction to where we try to find the situations where they're actually reporting on a situation that they were just in. We have not validated this yet, so what we actually want to do next is to when we do a thing where when we find these situations, then simply ask the user in the app, is the EMA you're filling out concerning the situation you were in 3 to 13 minutes ago? And based on the data, we would like to be able to see exactly when it was.